Both platforms are moving as quickly as they can to add more AI features and make, you can tell it to build automations and it will try to build out these different nodes for you, which is cool. But in general, I find I usually like to build these out manually anyway. So both companies are adopting AI. I talked to the VP of product at make.com and they explained all the very cool AI stuff that they have coming soon. But I would say that right now N8N is moving quite a bit faster. And one of the best features that they have is this AI agent, which is able to communicate with some sort of chat. It's able to respond to a chat. You can give it different tools so that it's able to perform different actions like looking up records from Airtable or producing a AI video through HeyGen. You can book calendar events or send emails. You can connect up a memory so that it can remember all of the chats you're having here. You can hook it up to a vector database, and they also have vector database tools which take care of a lot of the work that you would have to do manually in make.com. They just have a few more of these AI related tools that are more deeply integrated with their platform than Make does. Now, to do the equivalent of this in Make, you would need to build something similar to this. So in make.com, here is a Slack agent that I had built out before I had used N8N. And you can see here, there's quite a few different modules here that I had to put together to listen to messages from Slack. And then depending on what that message was, go down this path or go down this path and let's do this and do that. There's a lot of logic I had to specifically design, and it's actually quite rigid as well, right? Like it has to flow this particular way. And this automation in itself took me quite a bit of time to build, and it's completely replaced with this one module here. And not only is it completely replaced, but this is a whole lot more flexible. Instead of having to define all of these different actions and paths very specifically and therefore rigidly in an N8N agent, I can describe all of that logic in a prompt. I can describe all the tools and what it's supposed to do and how it's supposed to collect information from the user, all of which this automation was attempting to do. But what this agent is going to do is, through this conversation and using the prompt, it's going to figure things out automatically and send that information or that request to a specific tool. If it needs information to get this tool working, it's actually going to send a message back to Slack or to Telegram where the user could then respond. It's going to come back in and then it's going to send that message back in here. It can actually combine multiple tools. It can get content before it uses that content to maybe create an AI video. This is able to orchestrate a process on its own. Whereas in make.com right now, I have to build out that automation all on my own, and it's not even as flexible.